My name is Prem Ratan Baranwal. I work in the R&D department of Talentica Software Private Limited. Today I am going to present my paper on blockchain-based full privacy preserving public procurement. The agenda for this presentation is as follows. First, I will give the background, the context of my project, basically the public what is the public procurement, what is the problem that I'm going to provide the solution for. Then I'm going to describe the solution which is based on blockchain, in which I will first describe the blockchain technology, what are its advantages that can be used in our system. Then I will go over the auction protocol, which is used during the tendering process. I will give the smart contract design, the steps, the pseudocode of smart contract, followed by the analysis and the conclusion. So let's proceed. Introduction. So, public procurement is one of the government activities which is most prone to corruption. E-procurement systems, which consist of electronic sealed bid auction, has been used for bid submission. They have been recommended to increase the transparency, outreach, and competition among different parties. While good in intentions, they are still prone to fraud and corruption. So, third party or trusted software are used with the trust that bid recipient, whether it is the software or the person, they won't leak the bid to other bidders or manipulate the bidding process to favor the bidders. There is a possibility of tender condition change without prior notice. So this may either favor the purchaser or the auctioneer or some particular bidder. There is a lack of transparency in bid evaluation process. Sometimes the bid winner is not correctly decided. Sometimes the process followed varies from person to person, and so on. Even in the electronic based systems, tender conditions can be changed without prior notice. There is a need for bid privacy. So, in normal bidding process, once the bid is submitted, all the bids are available to the auctioneer, and he can see the bids and try to manipulate. Similarly, once the bid process is over, even the low bidders with the lower than the highest price, it is available to all the participants, and it can be used later to manipulate in the future bidding process. There is also a possibility that auctioneer or the purchaser may have hidden motives to favor a bidder or to cancel the bidding altogether. So if the bidding price is greater than the reserve price, but the auctioneer feels that it is still low, he can abruptly cancel the bidding process or something else. So it is in his hands to manipulate the bidding process or cancel it altogether, which is not right. And because of these problems, many honest small and medium enterprises companies stay away or look for a experienced partner before bidding for these public projects. Now, the proposed solution. So, we are going to use blockchain technology. Blockchain technology is a distributed shared ledger built on top of a P2P network that maintains history of all the transactions ever, making them immutable after the verification is done. Bitcoin, which is a popular digital currency, is based on blockchain. It's a value transfer technology that establishes trust between users and automates the payments without any intermediary. So here the lack of intermediary is important, because in our case we don't want any third party to be involved in the bidding process. So we would like to use this property of blockchain. Now, blockchain also supports storing and execution of contract code, which can be used to define the bidding parameters and evaluation criteria. The inbuilt consensus mechanism ensures the contract code is executed correctly and it is accepted by all the nodes, which all the validator nodes in the system. We'll also use a bidder resolved auction protocol. So normally in existing auction protocols, there is a auctioneer active participation, either auctioneers or there is a third party software or some kind of bulletin board which is used for the bid submission and winner disclosure. In our solution, it is the whole trust is distributed in the bidders only, so we call it bidder resolved auction protocol. This is based on cryptographic multi-party computation. It is based on multi-party computation, and we will describe it in the next slides. So I have already spoken about the advantages, couple of advantages earlier. Additionally, there is also blockchain also provides the transparency and concurrent and immutability. All the process is transparent to everyone, all the users, and transactions once confirmed cannot be altered with. We are utilizing these properties to make our auction system more secure and robust. Now, the kind of blockchain system we are going to use is permission blockchain. Permission blockchain is basically it's a consortium kind of environment where there are a selected number of parties involved in the process. It is not open to public, so only the users which are required are given permission, and they can participate in the bidding process and in the whole blockchain system. So we also need a smart contract. So we will need a blockchain which it is easier to write smart contract code, and along with that, it should also have the support for native cryptocurrencies, because we want to penalize users for bad behavior and provide discounts or other incentives if they consistently perform well, follow the protocol. We'll move to bidder resolved auction protocol. So before we describe what is the protocol, we'll first go to the cryptographic primitives used in the protocol. First, the first one is Elgamal encryption system. So let G be a generator of ZP subgroup GQ of order Q mod P, where Q divides, Q and P both are prime numbers and Q divides P minus 1. Also let private key be X element of ZQ and the public key be Y is equal to G raised to the power X. The encryption of a message in this case is given by alpha beta is equal to M Y raised to the power R comma G raised to the power R, and the decryption of the message given alpha and beta is alpha upon beta raised to the power X, where X is the private key. Elgamal encryption is also homomorphic over multiplication, as the multiplication of two ciphertexts alpha alpha dash beta beta dash is equal to M M dash Y raised to the power R1 plus R2 G raised to the power R1 plus R2. So this encryption, the multiplication of two ciphertexts is same as the encryption of two plain texts product M M dash with ephemeral key R1 plus R2. We are also using zero knowledge proofs, three zero knowledge proofs. Proof of knowledge of discrete algorithm. So if there are two parties A and B, and prover A wants to prove that he knows about something and to a verifier B, then both follow these steps. So basically they both know Y and G, but only A knows the private the secret X, so that Y is equal to G raised to the power X. A proves knowledge of X in zero knowledge by using following protocol. A picks a random number R in subgroup GQ, computes A is equal to G raised to the power R mod P and sends to B. B chooses a challenge random number C and sends it to A. A sends G is equal to R plus CX mod Q to B. So here we are adding R, a random number, to CX, so that basically we cannot find the X directly. B cannot find the X directly. B verifies that G raised to the power Z is equal to A Y raised to the power C. Proof of equality of two discrete logarithms. Prover A and verifier B both know Y1, Y2, G1 and G2, but only A knows X, so that Y1 is equal to G1 raised to the power X and Y2 is equal to G2 raised to the power X. Now we want to see whether in on what conditions G1 raised to the power X and G2 raised to the power X, they are in what condition we can say that X is same. So the protocol is, steps are as follows. A picks a random number R element of GQ and computes A is equal to G1 raised to the power R mod P and B is equal to G2 raised to the power R mod P. He then sends both the values to B. B chooses a challenge random number C and sends it to A. Then similar to the previous proof, A sends G is equal to R plus CX mod Q to B, and B verifies that G1 raised to Z is equal to A Y raised to C and G2 raised to Z is equal to B Y raised to C. We'll also use the third proof, where proof that an encrypted value is one out of two values. So it can be either one or Z, where Z can be any value in the ZQ. without revealing exactly which one is the case. So it can be either one or Z, but not, we are not sure which one. So there are encrypted values. The encrypted key is alpha comma beta, and basically at first A chooses random numbers R1 D1 W alpha beta, where A1 B1 A2 B2 based on these previous values to B. So in case the encrypted value is encrypted value is 1, he will have A1 B1 A2 B2 slightly differently calculated compared to when it is Z. And similarly, B chooses a challenge random number and sends it to A. Then based on the value of M, A again calculates some values D1, D2, R1 and R2 and sends it to B. Then B verifies that C is equal to D1 plus D2 mod Q. A1 is equal to G to the power R1 beta D1. B1 is equal to Y raised to the power R1 alpha by Z to the power D1. A2 is equal to ZR2 beta D2 and B2 is equal to YR2 alpha 2 D2. So this calculation will hold true if and only if M is equal to 1 or Z, but we are not sure which one. Bidder resolved auction protocol. Now we'll describe the exact protocol. So basically in our protocol, there will be k bid prices starting from P1 to PK, and each bidder will choose one of these values and rest of the values will be zero. So that will constitute a bid vector for a bidder I, which will be equal to bik plus 1 comma comma bi bid I plus 1, bi bid I, bi bid I minus 1 till bi 1, in which only one value will be 1 and rest of the values will be 0. The correctness of this bid vector can be shown by saying that all these values either are 0 or 1 and the summation of all these values is 1. So only one of the values is 1. The first step is to generate public key. Bidder I generates private key X plus I and MIJ R AJ at random and calculates public key YI along with the zero knowledge proof. Bidder I fetches other bidders' private public keys and calculates Y, which is a distributed public key. The next step is to encrypt the bid. So each bidder encrypts his bid as follows. He computes BAJ is equal to capital Y, where capital Y is element of group GQ, if J is equal to BA and 1 otherwise. He then sends this encrypted bid vector to the contract. He also provides the proof of correctness of bid in the zero knowledge. The next step is compute first price outcome. So I'll go faster over these calculations. He calculates gamma ij and delta ij and with the proof of correctness to the blockchain, and when everybody has computed the first price outcome, then decrypt outcome share is done, where he computes and sends delta ij with proof of correctness. The next step is determining the winner, where the auction outcome function is calculated using this formula VAJ, and if VAJ or VAW basically for any W is equal to 1, then the bidder A is winner of the auction, and that at that particular index the price is the winning price. So now we will write we'll provide the pseudocode for the smart contract. So there are 5 steps in which only the first step the auctioneer or the purchaser is required. So he will the auctioneer will deploy the smart contract with the code that I'm going to present, and the bidders will register there. So when the auctioneer deploys the contract, he will also do the initial setup in which he will describe, in which he will provide the bid price vector, the deadline and other stuff, and the bidders will register. So as a part of registration, the bidders will deposit the security money in the form of cryptocurrency with the auction amount and register their public key if not already done earlier. So now new bidders are added to the back of the list so that early bidders have lower indices, and this indexing can be used in case of tie breaking. We can use any other criteria for sorting the user indices other than apart from the time of joining. Next one is public key generation. Each bidder generates random numbers as per the protocol and updates the smart contract. After all the shares are set by all the bidders, each bidder fetches others' keys and generates a distributed public key. The next step is bid submission, where each bidder encrypts the bid and submits his bid vector to the contract along with the zero knowledge proof. Winner determination. So basically the protocol steps compute first price outcome and decrypt outcome are executed in this step, and decrypted outcome share is calculated by each bidder. This decrypted outcome share is used to disclose the winner. So once the bidder with the highest bid has confirmed his winning position, he can accept the auctioned item on the smart contract and pay the bidding amount. Once the winner has paid the bidding amount, C will refund, the smart contract will automatically refund the security amount to all the bidders. If the winner does not accept the item and he is not responding, the smart contract can hold his security fund as a penalty and the protocol is restarted by the seller after excluding him from the bidders list, as we already know that he has not accepted the item. If during any phase of bidding a malicious bidder who wants to break the protocol does not respond within the given timeout period, the smart contract deducts his security money and refunds, similar to the winner disclosure step. So this is the smart contract part. We'll move towards the analysis. Now as we can see, there are many advantages as listed below. there is no changes in tender conditions or bid price or any other parameter like deadline possible. Once the contract is deployed, we can make provision to change these parameters with some verification, either by all the parties or by the preset groups if we want. Then because everything is in the form of code on the blockchain, the bidding evaluation criteria is clear to all the bidders. Also, this instead of trusting a third party software or third party, the trust is on the consortium. So industry leaders can form the consortium, and they can check all the parameters on the contract code. So the trust is distributed on the consortium. Bid privacy. Now each bidder encrypts the bid before submitting it to the blockchain. So, and it is never decrypted. So the bid privacy is maintained throughout. Auctioneer or purchaser is not needed to evaluate the bid. So this is, I think, the highlight of our system, that auctioneer is not required to evaluate the bids. The bidders calculate the bid winner among themselves. Also, since all the transactions are recorded immutably on the blockchain, it is highly auditable at any point of time. So if there is any confusion or is there any problem, it can be easily traced. Also, we have come up with a small analysis of how many bidders can be what is the standard number of bidders and the bidding prices that can be used in our system. So for an auction with 10 bidders and 500 possible prices, a bidder broadcasts about 5.1 MB of data, and this broadcasting happens over a period of time and in multiple phases. So we think our proposed solution can handle the complexity without any issues in modern infrastructure. Limitations. There are two limitations. So whenever a malicious bidder is not following the protocol, or the winner did not accept the auctioned item, the protocol needs to be restarted. Because this is because the our protocol is based on N by N secret sharing, where all the bidders are required to complete the protocol to process at each step. So it is not possible to continue even if one single bidder is malicious. So none of the bids are leaked, but the bidding process itself cannot proceed. So that is one limitation. Similarly, due to the communication overhead, only a limited number of bidders can be incorporated, because each bidder calculates some values and transmits it to the contract. Once everybody has done the same thing, so there is a lot of communication with the blockchain system, and due to that, only a limited number of bidders can be incorporated. Also, as a future work, we are trying to benchmark this system on a Hyperledger in a permissioned environment, which is in progress, and we intend to publish the work in the future paper. Thank you.